Los Angeles. Welcome to Good Morning LaLand. I'm Dr. Aaron.
I'm Rob Mack.
And I'm Jess Moyer. This is Good Morning LaLand, America's first live streaming daily talk show, coming to you live Monday through Friday at 9 a.m. on Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. Also available on Apple TV on EverTalk TV.
And it's hashtag Thought Thursday. We're going to talk about the power of perspective.
Ooh.
So important. It's everything. We come together each day to know the truth, live on spiritual principle, align with universal law, and have some fun in the rain.
Yes, I know. What's
up
with
this? It's raining again.
Live from London. It's Good Morning LaLand.
Keep boring. Manifesting that destiny.
Yeah. This morning. I just thought I had an umbrella.
I know.
It would have been pretty.
Not a day for the suede shoes, I'll tell you that. I wore them too.
Absolutely not. But I love the hashtag mood. I'm a girl who appreciates the rain. It's the Michigan in me, certainly. Well, I'm very excited to welcome our very special guest to the show. Good morning, ladies. Back in the studio. Thank you for braving the rain today.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Oh, we're so grateful. You know, Samantha came all the way up from the OC. She is a confidence creator. Good morning, Samantha. We want to know, how do you start your day? What's your morning routine?
Oh, my morning routine is the same thing every single day. I have something called a morning reset. Every single day, I get up at 5:30 in the morning, I journal, and I have a mindset reset with devotionals, and then I journal out everything that I want to accomplish, everything I'm super grateful for, and everything that's going to make my day really, really good. And then I go to the gym every day at 7 a.m.
There you go. Get that engine revving.
Wow. Yes.
Awesome. Love that.
Well, one of the top business coaches from Norway is in the house. Gree, good morning. Welcome to Hollywood.
Thank you. I'm so happy to be here.
Oh, we're grateful that you're connected. So tell us, how do you start your day? Are you doing something differently in La La Land than you typically do in Norway?
Yeah, I got my hair and makeup done today, so it's kind of different. But normally I get up at 5, start with a workout, and then I do anything as that. I journal and set my goals for the week, for the day, and start the day on a high note.
What do you journal about?
Mostly it's about what happened the day before, and that I need to get, you know, out of my system if it's anything, and then where do I want to go? So my intention for the week, who I want to help, where I want to go in life.
Awesome. Love that.
Well, we are so excited to welcome a life stylist and the creator of Youology, Tonya, to the show. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for being with us today.
Thank
so tell
you.
Us about your morning. What's your routine like?
Okay, so I don't wake up at 5 a.m. like these ladies, I'll admit that. But what I do is I love Tibetan singing bowls, so I have a bit of a ritual that I do every morning. So I play Tibetan singing bowls, I read A Course in Miracles, and I have a lesson for the day, and that's what I journal about and meditate on before I do anything active. And then I tend to go for a run if it's sunny, but it does rain a lot in Vancouver, so I do yoga as well. So I definitely do something active after I do my bowls and my lesson for the day.
I love A Course in Miracles. Do you have a favorite quote from A Course in Miracles?
Oh, good one. Good question. Actually, my lesson this morning was about fear and how fear is basically a choice of what we can either let into us or let it go, and how we want to deal with perspective on fear. So I know that wasn't a quote, but that was my lesson this morning.
Fantastic.
Top
yeah.
Mind.
Fear is a call to love. I love it.
Yeah.
Ooh,
awesome.
So good.
Right? I know. I love A Course in Miracles.
Yeah, oh. It's so good. Yeah. And it always tends to be aligned with whatever's going on in your own life. Like, it is a miracle, that course.
Yes.
I find, like, every day, I was like, how did they know that? That's what's going on right now. It's like a magic book, I swear. So, and the bowls are great, too.
Of course. Well, thank you all so much for being with us. Certainly, if any of our audience is in a season of transition in any area of their life, they are definitely one to stay tuned for conversations with these incredible coaches.
Oh, absolutely.
For sure. They're all thought leaders, really.
They
right?
are. Yeah, totally.
It's not just Wealth Wednesday thought leaders. Thought Thursday. We'll just have
a
Thought Thursday.
I know, right?
I'll declare that right
there
now.
There it is. I love that.
So we have a big day ahead, you guys. We have got Round Table Talks with Ellen.
Oh, yeah,
actually,
Red Table Talks.
Red Table Talks.
That's
yeah.
that, too.
But it is a round table.
All a round table.
It is a red round table, so you are not wrong.
It's the next show.
Yes, exactly.
Yes, congratulations, Red Table Talk, on the launch of your second season. Thank you so much for extending the invitation. We're really excited to celebrate. Smith is going to be there, of course, her executive producer, who's a dear friend of yours, Ellen Rakuten. And, you know, they were nominated for an Emmy.
Yes.
This past year. So it just really shows the evolution of daytime television and talk shows. They are a digital show on Facebook Watch. and they were nominated for an Emmy.
Incredible.
So look out, we're coming for
right.
you next
That's
season.
Right, that's right, Jez, let them know.
And Ellen was Oprah Winfrey's.
Yeah, executive producer for 25 years. Yeah.
And you've worked with her personally, and she's been on the show.
I know.
Mm-hmm. Amazing.
It is amazing. I think what I found most interesting about the interview that we did with Ellen was that she said, hey, we made everything up on the spot, like the day
right.
of.
Like,
we just, yeah.
Too.
I know, yeah, thank God, we're winging it too.
I thought it was so fascinating. We listened to like a three-series podcast on Oprah and how it was a 25-year, you know, stint and how they began and how it was just this kind of just play it by ear at first. I mean, it was really amazing.
It
right?
was really grassroots, organic, and that's what kept the conversation so authentic and which really drew in the audiences. So we're definitely modeling ourselves after that.
Love 25 that. Years, I don't know, you guys.
25 years is a, can you imagine? Every morning?
No.
It's a marathon, not a sprint.
We're figure out something. Just beginning. It's a little insane. We're going a little insane.
Well, 25 years from now, you'll be like 46.
There you go, right?
So you're good.
That's right.
Yeah, being the prime of your life.
So what else? What else do you have for today? I know you have a lot of other things.
Mostly clients. I actually recently did Jennifer Schultz, who we had on the show, has a Leave a Legacy series. So I did that. Mm-hmm. That was fun. And I've got a couple more things like that, podcast and clients. What about you, Jess?
Very exciting. Well, speaking of leaving a legacy, today is the launch of the Red Carpet Collection by Desert Daisy Jewelry. We're so excited. She did a very special photo shoot with both Dr. Aaron and I to launch this really, really cool collection. And it's one of a kind, handmade pieces with crystals. This is one of the pieces right here, this gorgeous ring. And I love her. I love her spirit and I love her work. It's very creative. So be sure to check out DesertDaisyJewelry.com. You'll see all the pictures and, of course, follow on Instagram.
Right. And she's a Soul Society sister. So. Mm. Yes, they did a great job. Her and Bernadette did all the photos. We'll post
these. Can we see the photos? I want to see the pics.
We're going to start. We just got the email this morning with all of them. So
can't tease it out for me and not show.
That's right.
Exactly. We're about to inundate your Insta feed. Stay tuned.
I love that.
Awesome,
so let's talk about Thought Thursday, talking about the power of perspective. And of course, as somebody who teaches subconscious work, we get how important it is. You know, even science, quantum physics has the double slit experiment, where basically the observer, I mean, that's how powerful we are, that the observer can observe energy and actually have it go into waves or particles. That's how powerful we are.
So based on the expectation in their head, they basically dictate what the outcome will be, whether or not that photon will turn into a particle or a wave.
Right.
It's unbelievable, really.
You're going to have to scale this all
back.
Because unless you're a doctor of divinity or an expert in happiness, when you're saying protons and positivity, those two are two very different things.
Yeah, so the way that we would describe it in the positive psychology or just the psychology world is that we call it something very similar, which is the observer bias. The observer bias or the observer expectancy effect basically is the idea that I can influence what you think and what you feel simply by the thoughts and expectations and desires and fears that I have in my head. And I can communicate those to you unknowingly, like unwittingly. Yeah, sort of like self-fulfilling prophecy. Mm-hmm. It's an easy way to put it, yeah.
So how do you be a natural, neutral observer?
That's very difficult because you're always, forever and ever, communicating something, right? So I think for me, the greatest challenge and opportunity around that is simply to find peace inside and to practice non-judgmental observation of myself, my own thoughts, my own feelings, and then naturally and sort of effortlessly, you communicate a non-judgmental energy.
Right. Yeah, the power perspective. And that's the whole point of subconscious work, is because we've had trauma or we've had whatever, we've decided something about life, some limiting belief, and then we see all of life through the lens of love hurts or whatever, right?
Right.
We just keep seeing it. No matter who shows up, no matter how much someone wants to love us, we just keep seeing it like, this has to be painful, and I'm gonna create some drama regardless of whether it's not painful. So we just keep looking through that perspective. So whether you believe at the level of a quantum level where you actually can shift energy through the perspective, or whether you can just come back and dumb it down into seeing where you can actually just begin to have a self-fulfilling prophecy.
Yeah.
It's, you know, it's how deep do you wanna go down the rabbit hole?
Yeah.
And I truly believe that we can actually change the actual physical construct of the universe with the power of perspective.
Oh, totally. Mm-hmm. And it's happening all the time, just through your own thoughts, right?
That's right.
That's the idea.
But I think before you reach some sort of level of awakening or pure happiness, and you're kind of in that in-between or very normal stage like me, you have to be deliberate about your perspective, because that might not come naturally to me. Ooh, I'm going to see this from some inner positive peace and awakening. No, I'm not there yet. But I will be deliberate about how I frame what I'm seeing. Mm-hmm. So for instance, let's say you're stuck on the 101, it's raining, you can't get anywhere in traffic, right? Rather than freaking out and realizing you're gonna be late and setting yourself into a panic attack, take a moment and think, oh, well, maybe this is the time the universe said, I'm going to meditate this morning. Mm-hmm. Now, for me, and if you're anything like me, you're gonna be really mad about that because I don't wanna be forced into a meditation, thank you very much, I'd rather get where I wanna go on time. But to Rob's point, the universe doesn't go the way you want it to go. So what are you gonna do to experience the peace regardless of the chaos around you?
Yeah,
that's a great
huge
point.
As it is.
I think the reframing is super important, and I think it's important for people to get that, that there's all kinds of coaches out there, and some just simply help you reframe things, and some people actually get to the core of the work. And I think it depends on the level and the depth of how far you wanna awaken. You can keep reframing, but then it's gonna be a lot of work to always have to reframe.
Yeah, it's
like
true.
You might as well
it's
get
true.
Down to the core of the weed and pull the weed out.
Well, even if you're busy digging the weeds in the core, you gotta be deliberate in the meantime.
For sure, no matter which way you're going at it, right?
You can do it, I think, and it's a great point because I do think they can happen in parallel, right?
Yeah.
So that on one hand, while you're having this very difficult experience, you reframe it in ways that feels better for you, and you know that when you feel better, you do better, so that's one. And at the same time, you can also be diving deeper to discover something that doesn't require reframing at all.
Totally.
Yeah.
Do both.
You gotta do both. Gotta do it all. Or you can just take a nap.
You can weed whack the weeds and then, you know, get to pulling them up later.
That's
whatever
right.
works.
Yeah. It's a good point. I mean, I wonder, so Aaron, you know, for you, do you remember the moment when you really began to master this perspective taking?
The difference was this for me, is when I first went to like transformational events and I'd come out and I'd be like, yeah, I see how I'm creating it. But then they'd keep all my crap would still come up and I'd be like, but just like trying shoving down and trying to still be positive. And it wasn't until I actually did some subconscious work where I just felt like free. There was no effort in it whatsoever. I went in and did trauma work and it was just, I just went through life. There was no effort in trying to reframe.
Yeah.
There was no effort in trying to be positive. I was just being.
Yeah, it's funny because I remember, so at some point in my childhood, my dad forced me to run cross country, okay? I wanted to be a professional basketball player. That's all I cared about. And one day, in his infinite wisdom, he said, you're gonna run cross country. And I remember thinking, I'd rather die, like literally rather die than run mile after mile after mile in the middle of a forest somewhere. And I remember the first time I ran a mile, I literally thought I was gonna die. So I convinced myself I had to reframe this. So the whole time I was running, I'm like, you know, at first it was like, I hate my dad, you know? And then later it was like, oh my gosh, I only have a little bit left. And then over time, as you begin to get better and better at running, it becomes more and more effortless. Mm-hmm. I didn't have to reframe at all because I was just in the high of running.
Totally.
And I think that spiritual work is the same, is pretty much the
totally.
Same.
You can do it any way, you know, it's just, it all comes down to the same work.
Yeah,
you reprogram the subconscious mind, you can do it very slowly and do habitual ways and then slowly reprogram it, or you can just get in there.
Yeah.
Whichever.
That's right.
Whatever works
for you.
That's right.
I could just
peace
take a nap.
With you.
So on that note, let's take a break. We come back. We're going to talk to our amazing guest today about how they have shifted their perspective. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Live from the Pasadena Civic Auditorium, it's the 46th Annual Daytime Emmy Awards, celebrating the best in daytime. So get ready for some major excitement.
Congratulations, by the way, on being honored tonight for the Lifetime Achievement Award. How does that feel?
Well, apparently this is the first time they do it for someone in the food world. So it's pretty exciting.
It's because of you I know how to poach an egg. Hi, Soledad. You know, we were just talking about how this jewelry can make us feel royal. How are you feeling
tonight?
Thank you.
Incredibly royal and a little teeny bit itchy.
So 16 years ago, is there anything you wish you would have known then that you know now?
That's a great question. I think what I've learned is nobody knows what they're doing.
So elegant and also fierce. I always say hashtag fashion speaks.
Oh, I like that.
Right?
I like that. What is this saying to you? What is it speaking for?
For me, it's speaking that you can be truly feminine and stand in your divine power.
Wow, I love that.
What a fashion moment!
And we are welcoming the team behind Disney Junior's Vampirina. Congratulations on your wish!
This program has continued for decades to change the world.
Congratulations!
Yes, go have fun! Celebrate! I'm so excited to see
you just blossom. Celebrate and honor the hard work and talent of those who bring your favorite daytime programs to life. It's been an honor to join you. I'm Jasmine Moyet.
It's an honor to be with you on Connect TV at the 46th Daytime Emmy Awards here in Pasadena. I'm so excited to welcome the nominees, the presenters, the special performers, and the hardest working talent in daytime television. General Hospital Emmy nominee Lisa, hi, congratulations.
Hello,
Anthony Rodriguez, Emmy nominee tonight. It's so incredible to honor your friends and your family, the people that make your career a success. Vincent DePaul is such a man about Hollywood. He's always popping in. You never know where you're going to see him next. Thank you for sharing this spot.
I mean, daytime people are the best in the world, and I could not share it with anyone more beautiful than you. So there you go.
I appreciate it.
No. Carolyn Hennessy here in the winner's circle with the beautiful Jasmine Moyet, who took over for me, and I think is probably stealing my crown next year. Maybe. And we're just kind of discussing the red carpet or the Friday night.
Thank you for sharing your crown with me. It was such an incredible honor to cover the red carpet for the 46th Annual Creative Arts Emmys and to step in for you tonight.
It's fun.
What a moment to celebrate daytime television and that we are welcomed and representing this family is truly humbling, and I am forever grateful for this experience.
Oh, please. My pleasure.
Honestly.
Your show, La La Land, which I was on and which
yes,
I loved.
Thank you.
The questions you asked were so interesting for me and for all the guests that day. Your show has a lot of heart.
We really do. There is a positive shift happening in Hollywood, and that is heart.
I do think so.
Carolyn. I believe we are on the rise, and we are on the rise together.
Welcome back to Good Morning La La Land. On Thought Thursday, we have a great thought leader in the house. She is the number one entrepreneur business coach in from Norway. Gry Sinding is in the house. How are you?
Thank you for having me. I'm so glad you're here. Thank you.
Wow, the number one entrepreneurial business coach.
Yeah, I am.
What's that like?
Well, it's not that many people in Norway, to be honest. It's just 4 million of us, so that's easy to get number one then.
Right. 4 million is plenty, though. I'd love to be one of 4 million.
Yeah,
that's pretty.
It's a great place to be.
So you help people with people who are scared to sell.
Yeah.
People who are basically feel like success isn't for them, and that people who they just don't feel like they are worthy of tech. They're like struggling with tech. Mm-hmm. How did you come up with this niche?
Well, that was me, to be honest. Everybody was telling me that was the best kept secret and everybody should have a coach like me. But nobody was using me. I was like, no clients and struggling to sell. And then I had to learn it. And then when I learned it, I'm like, oh my God, everybody needs to know this.
Wow.
Yeah.
So how did you learn it? How was it going from somebody who didn't know tech, didn't feel like they're worthy, couldn't sell, to where you are number one today?
So in 2009, I started my business, and then fast as heck, I ended up on welfare. So it took me 4 months from being a big hotshot consultant in IBM to be on welfare. And then I had to sell my car, my kids' skis and Game Boys and stuff on we have a site that you can sell stuff. And then I went over to the US. And I just followed everyone that was doing it and said, teach me this.
So what did you change in your mindset? Because from the moment, almost desperation.
It was, definitely.
What did you switch?
It started with taking care of my health first. I said, what if I can do anything, what would I do? And that was to run a marathon. So I put a challenge, and I was at that time, I was like, I went from a big hotshot to a nobody in 10 months. And then I'm like, if I can get there, I'm sure I can get back, or I need to go back to my job. And that was scary. So the mindset that shifted was like, if I can take care of my body, I read so much Tony Robbins, and she said, like, you have to change
your state.
So I did I did an Ally McBeal every morning, and then I started running. And in 3 months, I went from sick and 10 kilos overweight till doing a marathon in 3 hours and 52 minutes.
Wow, that's fast. Wow.
It's fast, yeah. That's amazing. Yeah.
So you make a great point in that the same energy that can create scarcity is the same energy that can create abundance. And I think that that's such an important thing that people out there think that if they're just stuck in one space, I mean, it's one and the same.
It is. And Tony Robbins said something about it takes just as much energy to think a negative thought as a positive one. Why would you choose the negative one? Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh, that's a great point. I have to start this and then change my state with a song every morning.
I love that. Mm-hmm. So talk to us now. Now you're sitting number one. You have a, you know, whatever, million plus business. What does that look like? How do you work with people?
I live in three different countries. So I live in New York, France, and Norway. And I have my laptop and internet. And then I Zoom call my clients. I do Facebook Lives 4 times a week. And I connect with my audience that way. And I just teach whatever I teach. You guys are learning me something today, I know that. And then I just teach what I learned. Mm-hmm. So, and that's how I got connected with my audience. And I have online courses, masterminds, and yeah.
What are your favorite sales principles or techniques?
My favorite one is that the mindset that sales is more important than quality. Because many coaches is like, I have to get another course or another knowledge or something. I need to know more. And I'm like, selling is just a communication with the people you love. Mm. So communication, talking to bring clients. And that's all sale is.
It's a good point. We often get like stuck in like a student mode.
Yeah.
You just learn. You never feel like you're ready. You're just always getting ready.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I did that forever.
I know. Yeah. We all.
Yeah.
Fall into that
so
track.
What I teach them is the same thing that I am doing right now. I learn something from you. I go out there and teach that. Mm. So when you learn something, go out and teach your student that. So you get into the communication with your dream clients just right away. And then I take them from building a brand to getting audience and then 20% insta sales. And it's just a call to action. Like give them something they need right now to solve a tiny problem with your name and email.
Could you share with us though some of your success stories? Who's made the biggest transformation in their life from working with you?
So Helene was one of my clients and she was making $30,000 a year and very sick from home, so she couldn't have a normal job. And we just started doing online Facebook Lives, Instagrams, and then giving away her tips how she healed her gut. And then she created an online course and she made fastly from 6 months, she went from 30,000 to 300,000, mm-hmm. but just helping people healing their gut. So she talks about poop and going to the bathroom every day on social media, and now telling them what to eat to have a healthy gut.
Wow, interesting. Yeah. So what about the folks that struggle with the technology? Because I know, mm-hmm. you know, I'm a late adopter of technology, and it can be a little challenging and frustrating to like always be learning something new around technology. What recommendations would you have for people like that?
First of all, you need to learn how to dance. That's the first thing. So every time you get stuck, you just get up and move your body. Because I think also that is a mindset. Mm-hmm. So technology is hard, it will be hard. If you say, yeah, technology can be fun. And with Kajabi right now, I mean, you have to be ignorant to not, I mean, everything has
Kajabi, a, yeah. So yeah, Kajabi is a platform.
It's a platform.
Everything and it's amazing.
Can you tell us what that platform is? Because I've never heard of it.
Okay, so it makes it easy to collect people's email, to share your message, to sell stuff. And it's so easy that I have clients that are 65, did it in a week, mm-hmm. and never ever had a computer. It's like bought a computer and had that online course up selling their knowledge. Mm. So this client is selling how to knit. People are loving her. Mm. I mean, she sits at home by 65 years old and teaching people how to knit beautiful stuff.
Love that. I think a lot of people today are a little overwhelmed by the number of other people out there in the world doing mm-hmm. something similar to what they want to do. And they mm-hmm. think, well, why would I create a website when there are people on Instagram with 1 million followers or 10 million followers and everybody's focused on them? How are they going to overfill my website? So what do you say to people like that?
I mean, there's only one of you. And I think everything is energy. I don't think it's good bad people or bad people. I think it's just different energies. So you connect with someone and then other people connect with other people. So there's so many people doing exactly the same as me. But my talent is to kick them in the butt when they're not doing the job, and they love me for that. So you don't come to me to get cuddle. And so, but other people love to be cuddling and, you know, cheering on and doing the thing. But I will say, like, get you stuff together and do the work. This is your task list for today. Just freaking do it.
Yeah.
And so that's, you have to get your style out
there.
Don't
overthink it.
Yeah. I love when you said that you, whatever it is that you've learned this week, you'll give back through a live stream. I think it's one of the kind of tenets of the universe is you have to give away what you want to keep. And so tell us about how that works. When you do a live stream, because I'm sure there's people out there that have thought of going live, but they're a little scared of it. How do you convert that? How do you do a good live stream, and how do you convert it into potential clients?
You do about 100 shitty ones first. Yeah. So my first live stream, my phone went down here. I didn't know how to delete it, and I did that twice. So and I didn't know how to delete it. So you just
that's
had.
That's how she got the sale. Yeah.
But it's all making sense.
So that's how you just start doing it, mm-hmm. and then you need to learn the system. And the system is super simple. You share the challenge that they have and the solution that you can help them with. And then if you want more, click here. Or you just say comment below, or a call to action can be, you know, tell me the name of your dog or whatever. I mean, it can be so super simple, but you have to start with small stuff.
Right.
So, I mean, you're already selling, like, give me a heart in the comment field. That's the sales. Mm-hmm. And then after you've done that for a while, you go into more, you know, pay me money.
I'm sure you're going to tell us just to get a picture with Drake and post it to your Instagram. Which would be done. But now it's more than that.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for all that you do. I'm so excited because I heard a rumor that you're actually going to be moving to Los Angeles.
I am.
So we're really excited to have you here.
Thank you so much for having me.
Tell people how they can find and follow you and potentially work with you.
So it's on Instagram, GrySinding, GrySinding. That's about it. Thank you for having me.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
On EverTalk TV. I am so excited.
This is CEO with Anna David
and Lauren Wallet.
Welcome back to another episode of Mind, Body, Spirit. I'm Dr. Kate.
My people, this is Table for One, and I'm Leah Sergakis.
It is time for another episode of Sassy and Single, because that's what I am. I'm your host, Natalie Sadie.
Erica Dela Cruz, the hashtag passionista. You are watching Passion to Paycheck.
Welcome to another episode of Purpose. I am your host, Brittany Zonker.
Welcome back to On That Note. I'm your host, Elizabeth Lake.
She shares all her tricks in her new book, Your Healthiest Healthy, The Beautiful and Talented, Samantha Harris.
Hey everyone, I'm Lindsay Hoffman, and welcome to The Dose of Bliss Show.
Hi, I'm Valentina, and you're watching Ciao Bella.
Welcome to The Lisa Goodman Show, and every week I have
have the honor of interviewing a game changer in the wellness arena.
Hi, welcome to Defining Moments. I'm Suzanne Kwas.
Hi guys, my name is Serena Poon, and welcome to my show, Serena Loves.
Hello, I'm Lauren Francesca.
I'm Brad Grunberg.
And you're watching
How to Start.
Thank you guys so much for watching. You can always find these videos and binge them on EverTalk TV. Thanks for coming. Bye.
Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning La La Land. We are so excited to welcome a lifestylist, the creator of You Ology, Tanya, to the show. Thank you so much for being with us today.
We love your dress.
Pretty in pink.
So pretty.
So talking about hashtag Thought Thursday, and Aaron mentioned at the top of the show being a thought leader. How are you really changing the thoughts of the people you're working with to really become successful?
Sure. So I don't think I change their thoughts necessarily. I give them tools and a framework and ways for themselves to change the way they think and their beliefs in themselves, and just understanding what they're truly capable of.
So what is Youology?
Yeah, so Youology is a life design framework. It includes like five different elements of connection. So I call them elements of success. So every human being has access to these five elements. It doesn't matter how old you are, how much money, education you have. You have these internal resources within you, which are vulnerability, authenticity, curiosity, intention, and intuition.
I like it.
So you're connecting to those within yourself, and that's how you stay grounded and build your confidence and have clarity when all the external things happen out of your control in our lives.
So tell us about how you got to this journey. Most of the thought leaders generally have gone through something pretty hard. There was a moment when they said, okay, I got something to do here.
Definitely. So it all started when I had, you know, from the outside world, it looked like I had the picture perfect life. I was making good money in a corporate job, had the Mercedes, lived on the beach, all these things that you would think you would want, especially at the age I was at that time. But I was not happy. Like, I knew that I wasn't living the life that I was born to be living. So I just had that feeling of being very stuck, but I had no idea what to do. And everyone was like, you're crazy. Like, you're making as much money as a doctor and you're 26 or 27, right? So I just knew that that wasn't what I was here to be doing. I was in media, sales, and so I just quit it all and moved to New York. So I thought, you know, that's
don't
where I'll find myself. Yeah, you don't have to do this, believe me. It wasn't easy. And I was coming from Vancouver in Canada. So, you know, new country, new city. So I thought I was gonna find myself in this new city. And I soon realized that it wasn't the city where I was gonna find myself or the new job or the new relationship. I was gonna have to go within myself and get to know who I am.
Everywhere you go, there you are.
There you are. And I mean, the real pivotal story was I was alone in Central Park because things were not working out with my work visa. It was freezing cold. My nose ring was frozen in my nose. It was so cold. I was so alone. And I literally felt that everybody in that city had a place to be except me. You know, that feeling of just feeling so isolated. And I asked for a sign. Like, I asked God for a sign. And I was crying. I thought, should I move back? And I looked down at the pavement, and my name, Tanya, T-O-N-I-A, was engraved right at my feet.
Oh, wow. That's
incredible. I have photos. Yeah, yeah.
That's so amazing.
Yeah. So wow. God gave me a real literal sign.
And what did you take from
and
that sign?
So my perspective on that sign is such a good question. This was, I looked at it and I thought, that's it. The answers are within me. The answers are not in this city and not anywhere external from me. I need to take time now to, like, it was like staring at myself right back in the mirror, like seeing my name, you know? And then I didn't know what to do still. Like, I still didn't know what to do, but I did realize I wasn't alone. Like, I just needed to stop searching outward for my answers, and I needed to start looking within.
Wow, that story turned out so much better than most stories that say, I was alone in Central Park. It usually doesn't go well.
No, exactly. You know. Good point.
Yes. So what steps did you take from then?
Yeah, so then I became, like, pretty addicted to personal development. I became a certified coach. This is over 10 years ago now. I studied neurolinguistics programming, so NLP, and just really got to know people and just understanding, like, how much potential is within, totally, like, every soul, like, every person you talk to. It's pretty phenomenal.
We're not, like, so, I was so obsessed with it. We're not, like, I mean, everything is just, you get more perspective. Your perspective is, like, this thing. It's like a hit of, like, I don't know, like, you're just high on life. And you're like,
totally.
No one told me about this.
Yes.
Like, where is this, right?
What? Yeah, it's like magic. Yeah, it's like, magic. Okay, so if I'm going to see my name and I'm crying to God. And then it's like, what else is possible? Who am I going to meet? What conversations am I going to have? And it's just, it's this magnetic force.
Right?
It is.
The serendipity when you're walking through life like that. If people had any idea. So what would you say, like, for someone out there that's like, I don't get this whole self-development thing.
Definitely.
What would you say?
Well, I would say that success truly starts when you are yourself. Like, success is, it's impossible to be truly authentically successful when you are not a full version of who you are, right? So at least we should know that, right, to start. And then there's a process, like, and that's exactly what Youology is now, that I help, like, people can go through a very clear step-by-step framework where you are going within and you're getting to know your values, what you stand for, what is your essence, you know, what do you do that lights you up, and what do you do that, you know, makes you feel good, just all the things.
So what would you say to the person, though, who says, okay, I've got that all figured out, I know who I am, but this still isn't working out?
Still not working out. Okay. Well, if you truly do know who you are and what kind of impact you want to make in the world, things aren't necessarily going to just be easy. Like, you know, there's a lot of work, especially if you're launching businesses and everything. Yeah. So I think the whole point is you're always going to go through change, transition. When you go through transition, you don't have clarity. When you don't have clarity, your confidence takes a hit. So it's all part of it. And we're all part of this perpetual change. Like, that is life now. Transition is life in 2019, yeah. Right? Mm-hmm. Unlike our parents, like, they may have had one career, one marriage, one home. I know, you know, that's very common in generations mm-hmm. prior. So for us, like, we could have multiple careers and jobs and boyfriends and husbands and right. everything else. Homes, roommates, I mean, like, what? Yeah, it's exciting.
It's
like,
a whole new day. Yes. What's going to happen today?
Exactly. So we definitely have a lot of change to enjoy. But then that is where you can find yourself looking in the mirror, like, who am I? Like, who do I want to be at this stage of my life? And so we're just, like, doing this dance of reinvention. We're just constantly reinventing ourselves. And Youology is a way for you to go within and keep doing this framework and this process of getting to know who you want to be at this stage of your life. And that might look very different than next year or, you know, when you start a new career, you're a new person. When you become a wife, you are a new person. So that...
But I think, like, for someone like you, I mean, yes, framework is important. But I think that it's somebody like you that walks in and people go, I don't know what it is, but I just know I want to work with her. And I think that's probably what people have to listen to, is that intuitive factor that says, there's something here and I don't know what, because I don't think you can explain what it's really like to be in that space. You know, I think you just have to have some type of a trust and intuition. And I think that that's what you carry. I'm sure that's why the people that work with you.
I think so.
They're like, I don't know why, but I'm supposed to work with you.
Yeah, for sure.
So tell people where they can find you and follow you.
Yeah. Sure. So youology.com. So I spell youology, Y-U-O-L-O-G-Y.
Nice. Love it.
There.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. We'll be right back.
America's first live streaming daily talk show, coming to you live Monday through Friday at 9 a.m. All of these interviews are available as a podcast on iTunes, and the whole show can be seen on EverTalk TV, now available on Apple TV.
This is my first TV experience. I'm so happy I did it with you.
Thank you guys so much for watching. You can always find these videos and binge them on EverTalk TV. Thanks for coming. Bye.
Welcome back to Good Morning La La Land. We're all about thought leaders today, and Samantha Saget's in the house. She's a confident coach. She's built three companies before the age of 30, and you help people basically birth their truth. We're like sisters, soul sisters here. You're all about finding people their true you.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I am. Well, first of all, thank you guys so much for having me. I'm so excited to be here. And I just really started, you know, 6 years ago on my journey of just finding who I really wanted to become, and now I'm on a mission of teaching other people who they want to become.
Wow. How did you discover yourself? Because that was
the first step. Well, I found myself at 23 years old following the regular track record of success, right? Going to school, becoming a doctor. And when I was in school becoming a doctor at 23, I realized that this wasn't what it was cracked up to be. I was $200,000 in debt. I was sick and tired of being sick and tired already at 20.
America's first live streaming daily talk show, coming to you live Monday through Friday at 9 a.m. All of these interviews are available as a podcast on iTunes, and the whole show can be seen on EverTalk.
Ever Talk TV, now available on Apple TV.
This is my first TV experience. I'm so happy I did it with you.
Thank you guys so much for watching. You can always find these videos and binge them on Ever Talk TV. Thanks for coming. Bye.
Welcome back to Good Morning Lala. On Thought Thursday, we're talking about thought leaders, and we have Samantha Saget in the house. She is a confident coach. You're also all about passive income, right?
Oh, yes.
And you help people come to their truth of who they are.
Yes, the true you. So first of all, thank you guys so much for having me. I'm so honored to be here. And I basically started my journey 6 years ago when I figured out I wasn't becoming who I really wanted to become. I wasn't fulfilled. And so I stepped into that, I took a chance and invested on me, and now I'm investing in everyone else.
I love that. So tell us a little bit about that journey. Was there a moment when you were like, yeah, this isn't?
Yeah, there was definitely a moment. So I was 23, and I followed the regular track record of what we're supposed to do in America, you know, go to school, get a degree, come out of school, and then go back to school and get another degree, like postdoctorate or law school or med school. And I thought I was doing the right thing by stepping into school, becoming a doctor. Mm-hmm. And at 23 years old, guys, I found myself completely sick and tired of being sick and tired. You know, I was $200,000 in debt.
Oh my gosh.
I just was on that hamster wheel already, and I thought to myself, there had to be more. There had to be something that really fulfilled me inside and out and also helped me financially. And so I stepped into that, and 6 years ago, my life has been forever changed.
But how did you step into it? What were some of the first steps you took to walk in that path?
Yeah, so I guess I just started thinking about my future. You know, when I was 40 years old, where would I be? Would I be tied to a practice? Would that be my life? Would that be my family? And so I started doing research, and I figured out that there is a track called direct sales. And I said, you know what? It doesn't hurt to try something, because you never know until you try. And at 23, I tried something that I took $208, and I've made it in over $3 million in the past 6 years. I've led over 30,000 people through mentoring and coaching them to be just more confident. You know, basically believe in others until they believe in themselves.
So what was that? What was the program or the product?
So the product is a health and wellness company, and we're 26 years old. And I started when I was in school completely part-time. You know, I was a full-time doctorate student taking 32 credit hours. But to be honest with you guys, I definitely hit a struggle at 23 on top of debt and being tired. My little brother developed a drug addiction at 15 to medication. And not only did it mentally really affect our family, but at 23, I found my parents struggling financially. So I had this debt, and I had these two parents who gave me a great past, and I just really want to provide an amazing future. So at 23, I took the responsibility of honestly taking care of them. And so I think when your purpose is strong enough, the how-to, to figure out what you have to do, you just do it.
It's true.
So what role does confidence play in that? Because you call yourself, you know, the confidence creator.
Yeah.
How do you define that, and how do you help somebody discover that for themselves?
So it's a really good question. So I believe that I have a core value of three C's. So it's confidence, it's community, and it's change. And see, everything starts with confidence, because what people really lack is confidence, right? And if you can develop a confident self, a characteristic every single day, you develop this mindset, this positive mindset. And what happens when you have a positive mindset, you can go into consistent and constant action in anything in life. But what happens in this world, because of noise and we step out into our everyday lives, we turn on the news, we go into our company, we see our family members, people are negative. So I've developed this community to create every single day a new confidence, a restart, a refresh button for people around me. You become the vibe of your tribe. I truly believe that. The average of the five, you know, we've heard that how many times. And I've created a community where people can reset and refocus every day. And then change is my last C, because if you're not growing and you're not progressing, how can you change?
Well,
you need to change to do those things.
And passive income helps the vibe of the tribe, not gonna lie. So let's talk about
you
that.
Have
so
no idea.
We believe that, you know, I believe that you can't have true spiritual freedom without financial freedom. So let's talk a little bit about the passive income. How do you help people do that?
So you just saying that, I really believe in mind, body, soul to be the best physical, mental, and financial part that you can become. You want me to go into passive income of how I create it, or?
Yeah, how do you help people create passive income?
So it depends what you're interested in. I help people mainly, you know, whether it's real estate or direct sales or other passive income streams, I help them find their daily routine. I help them reset their mind every day. Like you guys asked me this morning, I really believe in mindset reset.
Totally.
And I give them steps every single day to walk through their specific business techniques. Last night I did a webinar on consistency. And I think one thing that makes or breaks success and failure is consistency.
Completely.
And if you're not consistent with all of those things every single day, how are you going to create a business, let alone passive income? So passive income will flow freely once you flow freely. So it starts with confidence.
Love that. Mm. So tell people where they can work with you, find you.
Yeah, for sure. So first of all, you can find me on SamanthaSagot.com. My last name is S-A-G-O-T, and it'll be on there. But also find me on Instagram. So what I'm finding with Instagram is I love to do the video talk text back on the direct messages and really get to hear people's stories and their voice. I believe that everyone's story matters and it adds value to every single person's life. But what I do on a monthly basis in my Serve, Sell, Live Well program is we focus on a topic. And the topic can be for personal growth, business growth, or just even life growth. Because at the end of the day, even if you don't own a company or you're not working for a company, every day life is a sale. You're selling yourself. I'm selling myself to you guys right now. I'm currently single. I'm selling myself on this dating app. I'm like, what is even going on? You know, you sell yourself to your husband, your wife, to your family, to your current career, to keep your job, to interview, to get a raise, and you sell yourself if you own a business. So what I teach monthly is personal growth, business growth, and also just life growth. And it's one topic a month. I go in there once a month and I train on it. We also have a ton of resources. And then I have an expert come in on the topic once a month. And then we also do in-person retreats and workshops, which is super fun.
Amazing.
Fantastic.
Thank you so much
for all of you.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Where can you watch the stories of people changing the world? EverTalk TV, the Netflix of talk. I'm Jessica Moyer, the co-founder and host of EverTalk TV, and I am thrilled to introduce you to America's first live video streaming talk show network. EverTalk is a platform that offers insight, inspiration, and thought-provoking conversations on positivity, wellness, Instafame, and empowerment, all while celebrating the trials and triumphs of those who are truly igniting a change in the world.
I was really surprised and I was really thankful for how well it was received.
That's where your supernatural powers come on. That's where the magic happens. That's where you live heaven on earth.
I was left to research everything on my own because I'm like, nothing else outside of me is helping me right now. I have to figure this out.
When we want folks to be good teammates or to be leaders, you confront behavior, you don't confront personalities.
These talk shows are hosted by your favorite television personalities, celebrity entrepreneurs, and social media superstars. New binge-worthy content is added daily with exclusive access to featured products, services, and experiences available to you in the Ever Shop.
You have a universal sign to say, it's okay to take a nap.
Yeah.
Like the universe is saying, please chill out a little bit, you know?
Right.
So we need to listen to that.
Well, Jeslyn, you are absolutely beautiful and you don't have to try it at all. It's like I walked in this morning, you're the first person I met. I went, she is absolutely drop-dead gorgeous. And
tell me more.
As you said, pick up the phone, like turn that text. Before you turn it into a date, let's turn it into a phone call.
These talk shows are hosted by your favorite television personalities, celebrity entrepreneurs, and social media superstars. New binge-worthy content is added daily with exclusive access to featured products, services, and experiences available to you in the Ever Shop. EverTalk is hashtag community powered, and we are excited to offer you a free 30-day subscription to explore the talk shows that will bring you timeless entertainment, entertainment that will inspire, uplift, and empower you anytime, anywhere on EverTalk. Talk TV, your home for talk. Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning Island. We are so excited to welcome the Hands of Fury himself, Seth Fury, to the show. Thanks for being with us this morning.
I'm so glad to be back. I love it here.
Some Hands of Fury.
Everybody
does.
Everybody
wants that.
Exactly.
You are in demand.
All do. You know, the power of touch is something clearly that you have mastered.
Yes.
But it can really transform people's lives in a way that only you can really describe. You've experienced yourself. Would you mind sharing that with us?
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, the power of touch, it's everything. I mean, people need it in their lives. Not far too often people don't get it. So it's a beautiful thing in what we can do, how we can come in, touch somebody, and actually change their day physically, mentally, and really just set them on a path of a lot, you know, just a better day, because stress can completely ruin your day. You know, so if you're not feeling up to par, if you're not feeling right mentally, then it's going to cause a drawback in your day. So
I read a stat yesterday that 57% of women have not been on a date in 3 months. So they need you in their life.
Yeah. Wow. 3 months. That's a long time.
At some level,
wow.
Right?
Maybe that's why his business is thriving. Well,
that's funny. Yeah.
Well, I love that even if, mm-hmm. you know, they can't experience the hands of fury
yeah.
themselves, you've also provided oils. So let's
yes.
talk about that.
Of course. Yeah. So this is we work with oils every day of our lives. So this is like our specialty. So we know what clients like, what the best products are. So it made sense to actually put something together myself that I could put all of what I know, all my knowledge and experience into a product that I think is not only great for usability, but also, you know, beneficially with the essential oils and what it actually does for the person. So this right here is Cream of the Crop, the best that I could possibly think of and crafted into this one bottle.
What makes it Cream of the Crop, and what is it? There's two different ones. I see
absolutely,
Relax,
yeah.
What is it, Revive?
So there's Relax and there's Revive. The best thing about, they're all organic, they're all vegan. You have to get the right organic essential oils in order for them to actually be effective with, you know, their purpose. So by providing that in this, you're actually gonna get the causes that they offer. They're all based with sunflower oil, which in our experience is a very light oil. It doesn't clog your skin. So some people have very oily, greasy skin. So this is gonna be, it's not oily, so it's great. It's also great for a therapist, but it's not only for massage work. It's also just the everyday body oil if you just want to keep yourself, you know,
ready for the hands of fury.
Yeah. Exactly, yeah. So it's just a great all-around product, and I couldn't be happier about it. So, yeah.
Oh, awesome. You didn't initially start as a massage therapist, though.
No, in the music. I was in music. I think a lot of people have a vision when they're growing up as to what their path is going to be. And you stay on that path, and over time, if it shifts, you know, you just have to go with it. It's not necessarily like a failure yeah. type of thing. It's just a self-awareness and just knowing that I'm great at this, but I'm also great at that. And I feel more of my energy pulling me in this direction, so I'm just going to go with it.
Yeah.
You know?
I think it's one of the greatest strengths and gifts that we can cultivate is yeah. just being fluid.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because you can't always see, you know, 5 steps ahead. Like you and I were talking about this the yeah. other day. Like, sometimes you just have to be in that moment, you know, and it's like you'll never really see where, you know, you were heading to until you actually get there. Like, I would have never been in California, period, if it weren't for music bringing me here. Now that I'm in California, I was able to formulate Hands of Fury, and now I'm in this whole new path that I never would have dreamed of back in Boston. Yeah. So you just have to just go with life, because opportunities open up as long as you're just doing what you feel is good in your heart. And just rolling with it.
Yeah. The voice is butter, though. It's extra smooth.
I appreciate it. Yeah. I love it. Yeah. I mean, that's something that I'll always have for myself. I'll always love it and enjoy it. But, you know, there's so many different things that I'm well-rounded and good at, but yep. you can't do them all. You got to just, you know, pick them. And then in the right timing, you know, throw them out there a little bit, catch them off guard.
Yeah.
Have that, you know, in your arsenal. So, but, yeah.
What do you love most about your work these days?
I really love the idea that I can just be you know, I'm pretty much paving my own creative method of, you know, showcasing massage therapy. So I think it's really cool that I get to be creative. I get to be a trendsetter. I get to see how people are inspired by what we do, how they're falling in love with the art of massage therapy in ways that, you know, they thought was kind of like a hidden, you know, craft. Because before, I would say, Hands of Fury came out, nobody really gave that type of light that we do. You know, we make it cool to be a therapist. We make you excited about the work that we do because it's a great field. You know, you get to help people. So why not have it be showcased just as much as dancing or rapping or singing, you know?
Yeah, I think that's one of your countless gifts. I love the way you're able to take the work that you do, the massage therapy, mm-hmm. and marry it to social media and create these really yeah. fantastic, innovative videos. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Talk a little about that if you want.
Well, because a lot of people don't know how to do it. I fortunately happen to be friends with a lot of some of the top influencers. So, you know, as I spin my brand, and I'm like, okay, I'm obviously not gonna do their type of comedy because it wouldn't make sense with the fact that I have an actual business page and a brand. How can I, you know, bring in all the humor that we go through on a daily basis as therapists and actually make it relevant to people who have nothing to do with massage, but still find it entertaining? Like, whether you get a massage from us or not, you're still gonna be entertained by just coming to our page. And yeah. I think that's the cool part about it, because there's so much to it, but we know how to actually execute it because, you know, we have actors and we have so many other talents within us that allow us to really put it out there. So cool. It's all about bringing all your gifts together, putting out one product, and just making people love you as a whole.
Love that.
Well, tell people where they can find it. follow you and work with you?
The best place is Instagram. That's our biggest platform. So Hands of Fury, it's HandsOfFury. Also YouTube, the website, handsoffury.com. And yeah,
check it out.
That's it. Yes. Thank you so much. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
That was the curveball. That was the curveball. Unintentional curveball.
Show the camera.
Up to you to choose the winner. Is it Annie? Is it Haley? Welcome back to Good Morning La La Land. We have a young star on the rise. He is an actor, he's a writer, and he's a director at only 14. John, thank you so much for being with us today.
Oh, definitely. I'm very glad to be here.
So it was a little tough getting here, though, right? The rain and everything happened.
Yeah, the traffic. traffic and rain. You know, weather's crazy today, actually.
People freak out in L.A. that it's like something's happening. Like,
yeah.
Trees are coming down. You know, they're like rain.
But you know what? That's the power of, you know, claiming to the universe. And, you know, that's what faith can do.
That's right.
Yeah.
So talk to us about that. Obviously, you must have had a lot of faith to start at 14 years old.
Yes.
Direct, so, write and direct your own.
Yes. Yeah, so I initially started as an actor at 8 years old. I always had a passion for the arts, and I realized while I was growing up that I could use art to, you know, change the world, create an impact on the world. And, you know, I started at 14 because I was inspired by many directors that I have worked with in the past. So, you know, I started at 14, started doing my own projects, had a film called Fly Trap, which talked about, you know, because us as spiritual beings, we can't just, you know, judge someone and say, oh, they have the perfect life. So my film Flytrap talks about that. And, you know, I've been doing several projects ever since.
Wow, I love that.
Would you consider yourself an old soul? You're very wise for your young age.
Well, yes, I get that a lot. A lot of people say that I think like an 80-year-old.
Which is a very high compliment.
It is, actually.
It is.
Right?
Yeah.
So what do you believe? I mean, what is your belief when you're in the next role or whatever? What is your highest why for helping people? What do you want them to know?
Well, I want people to know because I am doing this for the people who keep telling me I can't do this. I'm doing this for the people that say I am not worthy. And, you know, because one of the worst things, because as human beings, you know, spiritually, we can't control many of the thoughts that come to our head, to the back of our head. But you know what? You can fight them. You know, that you can fight them, and you can start telling yourself, you know what, you can rewire your brain to positive thoughts instead of negative thoughts. Mm-hmm. And so that's what I wanna inspire people. I wanna inspire people that you can change your can't into cans.
Were you bullied?
I was. Yeah. You know, a lot of people were bullied back when, you know, when they were kids, and you can just, you know, because sometimes you kind of grow up into what people tell you. Mm-hmm. And, you know, our worst enemy, worse than, you know, any other enemy, is your own mind. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and Amen. that is something that, you know, like I said, you can fight against. Mm-hmm. And you can turn your cans into cans. Yeah.
Who have been your greatest inspirations or teachers so far?
Teachers. Yeah. So I'm gonna be honest. God has been my number one.
Love that.
You know, inspiration. And other than that, my mother has been a a great warrior and a fighter.
Wow.
We know that you're also being a fighter for some really great charities. Can you tell us who you're involved with and how you're giving back?
Yes, so I was getting involved with Homeward LA. It was a theater production that I was doing, but unfortunately, it was a great journey of the pre-production process. I had a great director, Isaac Gracia, but the thing is that because there weren't enough ticket sales, I had to take the harsh decision as a producer to cancel the production. But you know, anyway, the journey was great. Mm-hmm. The journey was great, and I'm also getting involved with Operation Water, Movie Karma. I want to shout out to Jared Milrad from Movie Karma. My teammates over there have been amazing. It's a social platform for social impact, and that's what I'm all about, you know. So.
Right. But the thing about you is that you truly feel like you want to make a big impact. And I think there's a lot of incredible actors, and they make an impact or whatever. They're just having a perspective just broadened just by their role they're playing and seeing it in a new light. But you have something, you have a mission. Like, clearly you have a mission.
Yeah.
And it's really inspiring.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Yeah. It really means a lot to me, yeah.
Yeah. So what is your greatest, you have a magic wand, you're on whatever role, what is it that you really want to create?
Well, like I said, I want to inspire people in any way that I can, and I just want to tell them, like, you can choose to use art as a catharsis instead of using vice as a catharsis, because that's what I did. I used to go through a lot in my past with physical abuse with my father, but by the way, you know, I love my father to death right now, and our relationship is as better than ever. And so the thing is, like I said, I want to inspire people. You can choose art, and you can choose to be a warrior, not a victim.
So important, such an important message. Yeah. Thank you so much for all the work doing and who you are for the world.
Tell people where they can
find and follow you.
All right, so you can find me on Instagram is @JEAN_NASSER_.
Fantastic, Roddy.
Thank you so much. Yeah. We are Good Morning Lolland, America's first live streaming daily talk show, coming to you live Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. And all these interviews are available to podcast on iTunes and live streaming on EverTalk TV on Apple TV and Roku.
We're waking up the world together. You guys have a beautiful Thought Thursday. Use your thinking for good.
Amen.
And you can subscribe, follow this amazing human being and all the things he's up to. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Yeah. And special happy birthday to Andy Walton.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, buddy.